is going to be tonight. You guys better get outside. You better get to an area that is away from light pollution, a dark sky area, and go check it out. So the Geminid meteor shower I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about because it's pretty special. It's a really, really bright meteor shower. So that means that there's a lot of them in the night sky. During peak, there's around 120 meteors an hour. So you better get out there, you better check that out. So why is it called the Geminid meteor shower? It is because it is found near the Geminid constellation in the night sky. So for those of you who maybe aren't really stargazers or don't go out that often, I'm sure most of you guys are, but for those of you guys that don't know and don't know where the constellations are located, there is one constellation that is really noticeable from wherever you are. I mean, like, I grew up in New York City, there's light pollution everywhere, so we didn't really see many stars unless we like went upstate or something like that. But we could always notice the one winter constellation that is Orion because of the three stars in Orion's belt. Super noticeable to the southwest region of the night sky. So again, you can literally look up and you can almost see Orion's belt anywhere. The Geminid constellation is gonna be just above the Orion constellation. And that's gonna be the area where the majority of the meteors will actually be coming from, but you can see the meteors all over the night sky. So it's gonna be starting around 10 p.m. is when the meteor shower will actually begin, depending on wherever you guys are in the northwest or the northern hemisphere area. And then it's gonna go till about 2 a.m. 2 a.m. is gonna be the peak. And then around 3 a.m., the moon is actually gonna be rising. So there will be some moonlight there. It's gonna be a little bright. It might kind of wash out some of the night sky. So it might be a little more difficult for you guys to see the meteors. The moon isn't going to be that bright. Last year we had a huge problem. It was like a super moon going on. It was a full moon. It was really difficult to catch the meteor shower. But this year it's going to be a very thin waning crescent. So it's actually not going to be that bad. So if you guys are going to be up late, and that's one thing. I think if there's one thing, if you're going to be an astronomer, or even if you just want to be like an amateur astronomer or stargazer, step one is you're gonna need to be a night owl. You're gonna have to know how to stay up late. So I'm gonna be drinking a lot of my coffee tonight, and then I'm gonna be going out to the beach and checking out the meteor shower. So I want to talk to you guys a little bit about meteor showers and why it's also called shooting stars. So the thing is, first of all, it's not a star. Stars do not shoot, stars do not fly all over the place. I mean, possibly if their trajectory is being thrown off from something, they might fly, but that's usually through like a collision of a galaxy or something like that. But stars usually stay in orbit. They look like stars to us because here on Earth, you see something bright in the night sky. I mean, people think when you see Venus or Jupiter, unless you really are trained to know that, you know, Venus and Jupiter aren't gonna really twinkle, they're not gonna flicker, you might still think it's a star. Which, little fun fact, if you guys are looking at the night sky and you see a really bright, what you think is a star, but you don't really know where things are in the night sky, if you see it and it looks very, like, not twinkly, and it looks like it's staying constant with its brightness, most likely that's gonna be Venus or Jupiter. So definitely check your sky map apps. So anyway, so what's interesting though about this meteor shower is that it's debris coming from an asteroid. So that's usually what meteor showers are, and these shooting stars are, is it's debris that are burning up in Earth's atmosphere. And when we see that, that's what we see, is this, like, you know, it looks like a shooting star. You see this little trail and then it disappears. It's because it's literally entering and burning up in our atmosphere, because our atmosphere is really intense, a lot of heavy elements. This is why, I mean, rockets and the space shuttle program also had like really durable, thick thermal protection systems. And that's because the atmosphere is so thick and heavy with elements that, and it's also really hot, plasma starts to form. The electrons get really excited, but I'll talk about that in another video. So, what's interesting about this meteor shower, the Geminid meteor shower, is this is debris coming from an asteroid known as 3200 Phaethon. And this is an asteroid that orbits the sun once every 1.4 years. What's interesting is actually because of Jupiter's gravitational pull, its orbit is actually slightly getting closer to Earth. Just a little bit, don't worry, we're not going to be colliding with it, we're totally fine. But it is getting a bit closer, and so this is why we're actually going to be seeing like a lot of meteors. We're going to be seeing a lot of its debris because it's literally leaving. It's different than a comet, where a comet leaves like a tail. This one, it's the asteroid's traveling and it is breaking pieces are breaking off of it. It's leaving a bit of like a little dust trail, and we're coming into orbit with that dust trail. And that's why we see the meteors. That's why it's just the pieces coming from the asteroid and it's entering our atmosphere. And then it burns up and it looks like shooting stars. So that's what's so interesting about it, as opposed to like Halley's Comet, which is when that passes by us, we have a whole meteor shower also, and that's pieces that break off from the comet. So that's gonna be really interesting. So you guys should definitely check that out. I think it's gonna be super beautiful tonight. And yeah, if you guys haven't already, if you're gonna be taking any photos, anyone out there who's an astrophotographer, first of all, I'm gonna eventually get into that, but I gotta get a better lens for this camera. But if you guys are gonna be posting any photos or videos, totally tag me in it. I'd love to see some of your work on Instagram or Facebook. My name is Astro Athens on all of those channels, or even here on YouTube. Just tag me in it. I'd love to check that out. So yeah, I hope you guys like this video, and totally get out tonight and check that out. If you guys haven't subscribed already, please do subscribe and leave a comment and let me know what you might want me to do in my next video. There's going to be a lot of really cool astronomical events coming up soon. The winter seasons are really fun because they're the best constellations in my opinion. So yeah, well, thanks for watching guys, and cheers, and goodbye from Sally Ride, my little Lego figurine of Sally Ride. She says bye. Bye.